Okay, so I'm going to actually show y'all how I do my layers in Clip Studio Pro or Clip Studio Paint EX. That's the program I'm working in. That's the program I like to use. Now, I already drew this, and when I drew this, you know, this was just a practice drawing so I could get back into the rhythm of things, the rhythm of my art and everything like that. So I already got this piece. So real quick, I'm going to break down how I use layers in Clip Studio, you know. So first of all, you know, after I get, this is my line art right here. This is my flushed out line art. How I started first, let me show y'all. You know what I mean? I just did this right here. First layer right here. This is a layer. These are layers. See, I got 1, 2, 3. This is the background layer. This is the paper layer. This is what they call it, the paper layer. This is my transparent layer. My first transparent layer that's on top of the paper layer. The paper layer does not get touched. It's just the transparent layer that I'm using and everything. And I'm just using a regular layer right here. There is an option to use what they call that in Illustrator, vector. But I don't use vector because I really don't understand it to a full degree. So here we go. I have this layer right here on top of the paper layer, and this is just a sketch layer that I had the opacity down. But I started off like this, so this is all the way up. I was just doing my red pencil sketch, just so I could shape everything out. You know what I mean? My cross hatch and everything, get everything lined up. That's my red pencil sketch. After I did the red pencil sketch, I toned it down so I could just see, get a light outline right here. And then I added an extra layer right here. And that's my finished outline layer right here. And I take away the bottom outline layer. Now I have a clean layer, outline layer. So, and before I go on right here, you know, the brush, whatever brush you use, it really doesn't matter. But the stabilization, I always have it low when I do my sketched out layer so I could be fluid in my drawing and everything. Then I turn up that stabilization over here. I turn up that stabilization when it's time to do the clean lines, so the lines can come out as smooth as possible. I turn the stabilization to 55. That's good enough for me to have it smooth as possible. Now, let's move on from here to this point. Let's move on and make that next layer, which what I do is that I actually create a folder. He says right here, you see, I click this button, this little button right here that's next to the word that says layer. I click that and it says create folder and insert layer. So I do that. So now I created a folder because the way when you create these folders, it will be easier for you to manage all the layers that you're going to establish in your art piece. Now, I created the folder. Now I select the layer that I'm working with. The layer that I'm working with is the line art, the clean line art right now. I chose to use a dark brown for the line art, but I could switch that line art if I want to. You see where it says the color shows brown. I could go here on the color palette and actually select black, go to edit, and then go down to change color of lines to drawing. So, boom, I could change that to black. However, I don't want it to be black. I just want it to be a dark brown. That's just what I want to work with today. So I'll just go and change that. And boom, I changed it again. I could easily just push back and just reverse the color, but I just did that just to show you that it could be done either way. Now, the next move that I'm going to make in doing my layer is I'm going to actually duplicate it. So I duplicate this layer. Boom, duplicate this layer. Now the layer, even the lines got a little darker and everything like that, which is cool, which is fine. We just want to have a duplication for one, to have a safe layer, to where if anything happens to this line art, you have a safe layer that never been touched. You just have a line art that you can actually work with. So you could either deselect that layer and go back to the original, or you could keep it and just go down to the line art that you're working with. Now, the next step that I'm going to do is actually get the select tool right here, what they call the magic wand, and then I'm going to use the magic wand to select around the image. Now, I always make my images all the lines connect and everything like that, because I want, you know, oh man, did my thing just crash? I was moving smoother than smooth, and then my joint just dipped out on me. It didn't dip out on me. It's good. It just, I don't know what happened. But anyway, I have my select tool and everything like that. And like I was saying, with my line art, I'd like to connect all my lines so the select tool doesn't get with inside of the image. I just have the outside selected. Now that I have the outside selected, I select this button to reverse it. Now, this image, the actual drawing, is selected. So anything on the outside of this drawing is not going to be able to be touched when I color with within the drawing and everything like that. Now, what I do is I create another layer. Now, when I create that other layer, I bring it down underneath the line art, and then I go to the color palette, select black, because I want a solid black layer. And I'll let you know why I have that in a minute. So I got my solid black layer, and then I produce another layer. And that layer, I want it to be white. So I go to my color palette, and I select white. And boom, I hit white. And I'm just using the paint bucket right here. I'm just tapping the paint bucket, and it's filling in the selected area. Okay? Now, as I, you see the layers that I have? I have 1, 2, 3, 4. I got 4 layers. I got my solid black, my solid white. I have my line art, and my secondary line art. All right? Now, I'm going to deselect that. Now, the reason why I got a solid black layer, because a lot of times I like to get a thick outside line of my image while the inside lines stay the same as I drew them. And how I get the thick outside line is I go to filter and I go to correct drawing lines and select correct drawing lines. And you see how it made my outside lines thicker? I can even make them thicker if I want to. I don't know if you can see that out there, but you know, that is me just making a thicker outline, and I could say okay. If I want the outline to be even more thicker, all I got to do is go back to the filter and do it again. And you see it's creating another thick outline. You see? Now, the reason why it's kind of going slow is because I'm working with a i5 computer. An i5 computer that is mid-range when it comes to the memory of the computer, the power of the computer, whatever you want to call it. You know, if I had an i7, this would possibly run smoother, but I like this outline. I like the thickness of the outside outline. So cool. Boom. I got 1, 2, 3, 4 layers. Okay? Now, I move to this line art, the first line art that I'm working with. Now, with that line art, I'm going to select my paint bucket tool, and I'm just making life easier on me to where I'm not trying to color every aspect with just, you know, by hand and everything. I select the paint bucket, select the color that I want, and then I start to fill in the first outline. So here we go. So I want a tan, a little like this color, tan, whatever. And then I hit inside of the skin. Boom. 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 Just do all the fill-ins, you know, all the fill-ins where You know, there's a lot. And the reason why I'm doing this is so I could skip the process of just trying to paint everything all at once. But I missed a step. I mean, it's not really missing. You could catch it because you're using a paint bucket to get inside. But you're also still going to have to use your brush to get into the little small crevices and everything like that that the paintbrush or the paint bucket is not getting. So I would just go ahead and use my white because my white layer has stayed the same as the image. Not my black. My black has expanded. But my white layer has stayed the same. And I just go to the magic wand, select the white layer. So now anything that the color in here will not go outside the lines, will not go outside the atmosphere. So let me continue. I'm doing all flats right now. The color flats, meaning that just a solid color as I go through this. So the color of her hair that I want to have will be, let's pick orange. And I got the paint bucket. And I just fill in all the wide areas with the paint bucket. All the wide areas with the paint bucket. Do as much as you can without having to use the brush tool to cover up the rest of it. It just makes life easier. Makes the workflow easier. You know. And I will make her eyes like a greenish, I guess, yeah, green. Now, sometimes, you know, if it gets too tight, it's just, you know, the distance of it, so you could zoom in. And you can get a little closer with your pointer and know where you're pointing at. Okay. Okay. Now, I'll go back to the orange. If you don't want to go to your selector, if you don't remember what the color, you just go to color selector, and then you select what color you want to continue to fill in with. All right. So, you know, that's just going to take a whole lot of time to try to get into these crevices with the paint bucket. So I'll just go ahead and get my marker, as my marker is the same, and bring up the size of the marker, and now I could just fill in the little places. But most of it's done. And you see how some of this is covering. And see, what the good thing is, when you're covering the line art, you have the other line art that's above that's not being tampered with. But now you're just filling in all the color in, you know, without having to worry about doing all the color through the whole picture and everything. All right. All you got to do is color the spaces that needed the color and everything like that. I'm just doing it real quick, so you know, a lot of this could be done a lot smoother. It's all about getting your workflow. Once you get your workflow, everything will would move much, much smoother, much quicker, and everything like that. You know, go to my selector, select that, go back to my brush, and just continue to fill in everything. Should have did this live. I don't know what I was thinking. Wasting camera. But there is gotta be something where all this, I could get this filled in more. It used to fill in more. I don't know why it's not filling in as much anymore. That i5 is slowing me down. So if anybody want to invest in me and get in an i7, I will welcome that. Right now, I'm only doing with what I can afford to do right now. Okay. But you see how it's coming out? Hey, and I don't know where that's the i5 will make me do stuff like that, and I don't like that, but, you know, I could just color over that, you know. Okay. And see, I have a fat brush, and that's why I'm getting, you know, into that, so I could just bring the size of that brush down and then, you know, select the color I need to select in order to get that smoothed out. Long as I live, you will be mine. All right. So, now that I got that done, pull back. And see, now I have that done, and then I create another layer. And now, as I create this another layer, I'm going to get my spray paint, and I'm going to get a black, and then that's when I start to develop my tones. And I'll show you how I'm going to develop my tones. Raise that, bring that up some. On a tarnished day. You know, put your shades in and everything like that. So I'm just doing simple shading, you know. The black tool, shading where I think, you know, the shade should be. Long as I live, long as I live. Dang, that's too dark. And see, this shade is on a separate layer. Because as I have it on a separate layer, that means I could control it better on a separate layer. I could, you know, clean it up as much as I want to, go over, you know, the image as much as I want to and everything like that with this separate layer without disturbing the rest of the line art or the color, the flat colors, you know. But I'm just doing this real fast, so a lot of this is kind of rough and everything like that. You might be thinking, why is it so dark? Well, you'll see what I'm going to do in a second, you know. He says, too dark, too dark. I get it. So live your being. I want it to be light too. So as I have my initial dark shade, you know, now all I do is, you know, I do that and then I just turn the opacity down. See, you get it down lighter, boom. Now that the opacity's down and everything like that, you know, it makes a softer look. You know. But all the time and all the while, you know, I'm not breaking my boundary over here. And that's good. And I could continue to, you know, flex on it, work with it, you know, flush things out, you know. So, you know, and that's on that layer right now. So how many layers do I have now? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 layers. Okay? Now, I'm going to create another layer. Now, with this layer from black to white, the white, now I'm bringing in light, you know. And I turn big to really get some, turn my size brush up, really get some size in here, you know. You know, just bring it to life, you know what I mean? Now, I click my button on my pen right here, and it's going to turn into an eraser. And when I have it an eraser, I could just erase certain things, and I could get that hard cut now. You see that? I got that hard cut. See that? So I'm gonna keep the soft tones on the face and everything like that with no hard cuts, just the hard cuts in the hair, just showing you what the hard cuts look like. Now I'm coming down to actually 6 minutes, and we're just gonna do a 30-minute stretch here. You know, everything else, this is basically the basics and everything with the layers. Now you see why I put it in folders, because I could collapse that folder and now your image is, you know, you don't have too much going on here. You're all just focused on this one thing right here. So the next thing I would do is I will actually, you know, go above the actual line art layer and zoom in. And as I zoom in, I'll select my brush again. I still have it on white. Oh, that's the eraser. and just bring down that, and you know. Nah, that's not how I like it. Now you could, I could put highlights in the eyes. You know. There's much more I could do in everything. This is just a quick little swing dinga dinga. Go back down to my line art. Not the line art, but my shadows, my shadow layer. I'm on my shadow layer. And let's see. Can I do that just with this? Go to black and yeah. I could fill in that eye with black. Make that eye, you know, that's where the shadow comes in. You see? You know. But anyway. I'm just doing some extra stuff right now. You know, just to bring it out some more and everything with the lips and all that. See me bring it out. All right, we're winding down to the last minutes. Like I said, I'm going to stop it at 30 minutes. Because my phone can't do too much this time and everything. You know. Just give it some tones and everything like that. But after you had, after you're done with that, you know, then you could deselect. And boom. You got your image. I don't know if you can see it. You got you an image now. Got you a nice little piece. And I could deselect the back if I want to. And then have nothing. Just have a straight line art to color. Or I could select it, whatever. You know what I mean? You know. I think they both look good. I'll keep that one. And then that's it. Then you save it. Make sure you save your work and everything. And then we're done. Thanks for everybody that tuned in. And that's a wrap. Peace.